Hello students, today we will see Z-shaped rule. The definition of Z-shaped rule is when two alkenes are likely to form highly substituted alkenes more stable. And I have taken one example CH3, CCH3, CHOH, CH3. And here I have taken a catalyst of sulfuric acid, so H plus and HSO4 minus. While I'm writing these ions of H plus and HSO4 minus, I have written as H plus and minus OSO3H, because between oxygen and hydrogen and the sulfur, the electronegativity of oxygen is 3.5, sulfur electronegativity is 2.5, hydrogen electronegativity is 2.1. So what the more electronegative values for oxygen, so I have written a minus near oxygen. So I'm supposed to write H bond OSO3H. This is the way of writing the formula of sulfuric acid. So here the oxygen, many times I told you oxygen atomic number is 8. Next nucleus, first level 2 electron, next level 6 electron. So the valency of oxygen is 6. So here 2 lone pair of electron on oxygen, and 5th one and 6th one is shared here. So what I need, only one lone pair. So I exhibited one lone pair of electron is donated to the hydrogen, and automatically this bonded electron is shifted to oxygen. It attracts because. So it is minus OSO3H is left out, and here H only is the new entry for this compound. So CH3, CCH3, CH3, single bond C, single bond CH3, single bond OH is the compound, but this blue color H bond is a new entry. So what this, after donation of this electron to this hydrogen, it becomes a plus. So to neutralize this, this bonded electron is shifted to oxygen. So once it has gained electron, it has started to eliminate as a water. So it is minus H2O. So we have CH3, C, CH3, CH3, single bond CH, single bond CH3. After losing this bonded electron, it acquires plus. So this is called carbanion. This carbanion in a secondary carbanion, because now I'll tell you the order. I mean that the order of the stability of carbanion is tertiary carbocation, carbocation. So this carbocation, the 3 degree C plus is a tertiary carbocation, 2 degree CH plus is secondary carbocation, 1 degree CH2 plus is primary carbocation. Among this carbocation, only the tertiary carbocation is more stable than secondary carbocation and the primary carbocation. But where we got a secondary carbocation? So now let us write in a two different style of this formula, because either this hydrogen may give the electron by the elimination H and bonded electron may be donate here, or this CH3 group will be shifted to here and make this carbon as a tertiary carbocation. There is a two possibilities. So I have written here in two different style. One is CH3, CCH3, CH, CH3, and this I am going to shift. So I have kept ready for bonded CH3 in red color. Next one is CH3, CCH3, CH3, CH. This CH3 I took outside the H to ready to donate the bonded electron. So for, let us see this secondary carbocation. This bond is shifted here, and this hydrogen is eliminating, this bonded electron is getting inside. So what, this becomes double bond. So after beta elimination of H plus, it acquires CH3, CCH3, CH3, CH, this double bond CH2. So this full thing is attached to this CH2, only one alkyl, one alkene group. This is called a neopentyl. So only one alkyl is substituted. So it is very, very less stable. So that is only the percentage is 3. So now let us see this another style of writing this. This CH3 bonded electron is shifted to the secondary carbocation. So it is called methyl shift. So consider this is 1 and this is 2. So it is called 1-2 methyl shift. So see, after shifting the methyl group, CH3, C, CH3, CH3, and here it is a this bonded CH3 is shifted to here. Then it acquires a tertiary carbocation. So tertiary carbocation is more stable than the secondary carbocation. So let us see whether we are getting high yield or not. We will see. So here there is a two possibilities. Either this hydrogen can donate the electron by losing hydrogen. Hydrogen bond can donate here, or this hydrogen can donate here. So what I have written in the two forms, one is CH3C, this H I have written on top. The H is removed by bonded electron is donated here to neutralize this deficiency species. So we got it CH3C, CH3. Double bond CH3. Now we got a four alkyl group. One CH3, CH3, CH3. Four alkyl groups are there. So it is the yield is 64%. The substitution is 2 methyl group and 3 methyl group. So 2, 3 dimethyl butoene is the formula. 64%. Now next one is this CH3. One of the hydrogen will be donated here, bonded to here. So this CH3, one of the hydrogen I exhibited, I have written like this, bond and H. So this bonded electron is donated to this deficient species after removing of the H plus. So water, this becomes CH2, double bond, CH3, single bond, CH3 here. CH2, double bond, CH3, single bond, CH3. So here only two alkyl groups are substituted. One methyl group, another thing is CH3 is isopropyl. So methyl and isopropyl are the two alkyl substitution. So the percentage is only 33%. So when the carbocation is secondary carbocation, we got only 3% because it formed only one alkyl substitution. When the carbocation is transferred to tertiary carbocation, means we got a 33% and a 64%. 33% because of two alkyl group is formed, and 64% we got a four alkyl group is formed. So this is called a Z-shift proof. Thank you, students.